Hi guys, it's Tony again. This time we're looking at standard council car parking and comparing how big the cars are. Now look at the size of that BMW X2. You've got no way for the doors to open up either way. Are you going to ding someone? Let's carry on down and see what else we've got. So let's look at some various cars. Now this one here, this one, you see the problem you've got is, see how close you are to that other car? This is so small and so narrow that's why all the dings. Here's another one, example of a big family SUV. Now if you see where I'm talking about, how are you supposed to open the doors? Do you know what I mean? Prime example is this one here. So if he opens the door, it's going to bash that door. So yeah, it's just one of them. Here's an example, like, as I said. Look, there's no space for the door to open that way out. So you're just going to ding the car next to you, or they're going to ding you. It's the same with this Kia as well. So SUVs have evolved in size, but the car parking spaces have remained still the same tiny pathetic spaces, and they're charging you good money. They're still the same. So how is it? So you've got a car that's there. How is that car? That door is just going to ding into that one. Or if you're, let's say you're a big guy, and you're not going to be able to get out of that. You're going to need to open the whole door. They're just going to ding you, the guy. It's stupid. If you take a look back at this, there's just no space. Councils, they need to make these things bigger. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Leave the comments. Catch you later.